playoffs are here, and this matchup on Wild Card Weekend is brought to you by EA Sports. It's the Panthers and the Niners, coming up next.
It was a common sight in the 80s and 90s, not quite common sense, but it's back. Playoff football in the Bay Area here in Santa Clara. Tonight we continue with Wild Card Weekend with what should be a great one between the Carolina Panthers and the San Francisco 49ers. NFC Wild Card game. And we will not get a run back here to start. It's a touchback, and it will come out to the 25. Now the man from nearby Stanford, Christian McCaffrey. And he'll maneuver his way forward for about four. Second and six.
Well, on every play call, you realize it's not going to go for a touchdown. So a lot of your calls are setting things up for maybe later in the game. Trying to establish the inside run. Run with toughness now. Hopefully get to the perimeter later. And let's face it, you could do worse than a four-yard run on first down.
And he gets this up across the 35 before he's out of bounds. A gain of four last play. They double that here and get eight. On first down, this is McCaffrey. And if there was a lane there, it closed up quickly as he stopped for no gain. Second down.
Well done to sniff that out defensively. He had it diagnosed pretty quickly.
I love that description because diagnosed is perfect on that one. Read his keys, made the play, and he couldn't even get going moving the football.
And that play is blown up, losing yardage back at the 35. 2 yards the loss, and now third and 12. Now Stafford. And oh, he took that in one-handed. What a grab.
That is one heck of a catch right there. Got his eye on it the whole way and able to make the grab one-handed. Very nicely done and for a nice chunk of yardage, too.
Now a first down throw. Stafford. And that going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down. So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Back to throw, Stafford. Deception here on this opening drive, but he gets a reprieve. It's third down.
Pretty nice coverage there, but a missed opportunity for an interception. Let's face it, a lot of these defenders, they've got it all. Speed, athleticism, hands, a little bit questionable.
And the throw there going to be incomplete.
They went with the dive look that time on defense, just flooded the field with defensive backs, blanketed everyone, took away all the passing angles, thus the incompletion.
Now here's the Panthers special teams unit to try a field goal for three. This officially a 55-yard attempt. And this one will not get there. It's off to the left anyway. It's no good. These playoff games have a tendency to be tight. You have to wonder if that missed field goal could haunt them later.
Yeah, we're always looking for the key plays, right? The ones that we're going to magnify. Usually those happen in the second half or later in the game. This might be the key play of the game showing up here in the first half.
And Dowdy goes at the 49, a 3-yard pickup.
Give credit to the defense for stringing that play out, and they gave up no cutback angle. You know he was trying to dart through. No place for him to go. A nice job there, only giving up a 3-yard gain.
Now a throw here to his running back, and he'll be brought down at the 45-yard line.
One of my old teammates called me the other day when he was watching the game. He said, man, trying to watch an NFL game and trying to account for their passing game? That's difficult. And just when you think you get everything covered, here comes a back out of the backfield. And in this case, he picks up a first down.
Now left side, a completion to his tight end. He'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20.
Example of an offensive coordinator scheming his guy open, just a little underneath route, just trying to free up some space, and it worked awfully well. Got him not just space, but plenty of room to run after the catch to pick up really nice yardage.
On first down, Lance. That's complete to Mostert out of the backfield.
And able to get him down, but he does reach the five.
His passing's been on point on this drive, hasn't it? Been very accurate, gotten the ball downfield, gained nice chunks of yardage. But now, in this situation, the field is really condemned.
And across the goal line, into the end zone, touchdown 49ers. Kyle Juszczyk. A 5-yard touchdown run.
And the 49ers will strike first here in this wild card matchup.
Well, we knew they had the crowd on their side. Their defense has already made a stop, but now here's an opening drive touchdown.
Yeah, how about the defense making the stop, offense feeling their momentum that they've generated and turning it into points on their side. So now you've got a team working together, and they got the crowd involved, fully on their side in this ballgame.
And in this playoff atmosphere, that 12th man means even more. The Panthers coming back out onto the field for their second drive. They've been a come-from-behind team all year. They'll need to do it again as they trail early in this wild card game. And he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here, second down.
Certainly a nice job there by the defense, rallying to the football and getting him on the ground. But I think the play gets made by the defensive front, because if they can't get upfield, their job is to go ahead and get low, almost get into a ball sometimes, stack things up, and make it difficult for the runner to find a hole.
And he's got it. What a catch on the sideline.
Let's make this one simple. What a catch, especially the finishing part of getting his feet in bounds, toe tapping, and of course, foot dragging.
A little tapestry, if you will.
Oh, I like it.
And he gets this inside the 35-yard line.
Good running right there. And this is a man who's a 1,000-yard rusher in the regular season, so you know he's going to get his chances. And he picks up nice yardage on that one.
On first down at Stafford. And he will find the open man. It's DJ Moore. Touchdown! DJ Moore, 34 yards. And the Panthers have tied this game up. They can take the lead with the extra point. Extra point right down the middle. And they take the lead here at 7-6. So that drive, 4 plays. And the end result, a Panthers touchdown.
Taken in at the 3. And they'll get him down inside the 30 at the 27.
Back out there comes the 49ers offense, ready for their second drive. And for them, a touchdown their last go-around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
Throwing here to start the drive as they connect left side.
And as a quarterback, you always want to exploit gaps in a defense. And he finds one here. Crossing route, working from right to left across the field. And once you get defenders going in the wrong direction, it is awfully hard for them to pivot back, and you end up getting the first down.
Now he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down. But you often say that sort of opens the playbook now, second and short. What do you think, early shot here?
I like where you're going. Obviously, we've been together for a while because you know me. I want to take that shot early and loosen things up.
The last run got 9. That leaves him with 2nd and a yard. To throw, it's Lance. This will be caught. It's Samuel. And he gets this one inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10.
And time to give some credit to the big fellas, the offensive line here, because you've got to have good protection on crossing routes because you've got to give your receiver time to work all the way across the field. That time, able to scan the field, spot his receiver moving left to right, and make a good, accurate throw. Thank you, guys.
The 49ers with the football here to begin the second quarter, as they've got it with a 1st and 10. And he'll fight his way down inside the 10 to the 9-yard line. Give him a couple on the carry there, second and 8.
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held him to a gain of 2. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. Second and 8. Now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
And the Niners are going to be set up with a first and goal on a pass play that moves him all the way down to the 1.
Many different ways to create space, but on that play, he did it with that big, wide body of his. Didn't get a whole lot of yardage on the play, but it did what it was supposed to. Pick up a first down.
Mostert will score. Touchdown, 49ers. So it was the passing game that got him down here, but closer to the goal line, it's the running game that gets him home.
Certainly appears that they lulled the defense into thinking that the passing game was going to be it the entire drive. Nice change up there going to the running game to get him over the goal line.
They'll look to throw. They'll roll him out right. And he's going to be taken down. It's a sack. And they fail on the try for 2. Tried to roll out, make a play outside of the pocket, but couldn't get it done.
When you don't have a lot of space for your receivers to operate, and down there it's really condensed when you're snapping the ball from the 2-yard line, rolling out, you extend a play, but you don't necessarily open up better avenues for people. And on that play, there's just nowhere to go with the ball, and you end up getting sacked.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you score points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
Following the pickup of 4, here's 2nd and 6. To throw is Stafford. Throw left side, complete. That's Moore. They'll try and pick it up with McCaffrey. And he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36.
On third down, that's a good job of situational football and understanding where the first down marker was and getting there.
Stafford on first down. And this is Parker, complete. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up 2nd down. They'll give it up to McCaffrey. And he'll get it out a couple yards shy of midfield at the 48. Solid running there. And CD, we hear so much about what a running game and their assessment. Backfield, this group has a strong running game without a doubt.
Oh, I absolutely agree with you there, because in terms of yardage, he's a top 5 running back in the league. And in terms of impact on a game, not many better than him. And when they're flowing and he's carrying the ball consistently, they're tough to beat.
Now a play fake at Stafford. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And he's got this down a yard or 2 shy of the 40 before he's out of bounds. And they went the wrong way there. Losing yardage back at the 43-yard line. Officially, it's a 1-yard loss. That's going to bring up 2nd and 11. And that play going absolutely nowhere as he's belted before he could get out of the backfield. Now, after that last running play, we've got an offensive lineman down on the field. Well, he gets attended to. We'll step aside. The Panthers on 3rd down. They've been okay. 2 for 3 thus far. This is going to be 3rd and 13. Now Stafford. And he's got the hook up to Moore. Touchdown, Panthers. DJ Moore with his 2nd touchdown here in this first half. And the Panthers are going to jump back in front. Extra point splits the uprights, and the lead is now 2. So that one, a pretty time-consuming 10-play drive. And Carolina scores to cap it off. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. And San Francisco gets set to go here. On the ground, it's Mostert to start the drive. And he'll work this forward for about three at second down.
They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here. And if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of first downs. Run some plays, run some clock. Allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just gave up a score.
2 minutes to play here in this first half of the NFL playoffs. Coming up at the half, we remind you that we're going to do what we've done all year. We'll get you down to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. Coach will have the lowdown on what's going on here in this wild card weekend as we begin the road to the upcoming Super Bowl. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. Faking the give to Mostert. Now Lance. Flush to his right. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
Whenever yourself, the receivers on that side of the field, their number one job, make sure they get in his sight line so he can try and find someone downfield. Guys on the backside, make sure you don't give up the deep ball. They tried it there. They weren't able to connect.
Throwing again on second. Mostert hit and he drops the ball. And it's picked up by the Panthers. And to the 43. So down inside the 45 to the 43-yard line. That's where they'll take over. And now that's where the potential turnover. So that one overturned. They say the knee was down, and that will not be ruled a fumble. Following the fumble recovery, Lance, and able to haul it in is Kittle. And he is going to have the Niners first down by about a yard as they're able to convert on third and two. Lance now on first down, eluding the pressure right. Now he'll let it go deep right side.
He certainly had a good game throwing the ball so far, but I think he was trying to take that from good to great with that throw, trying to get one downfield.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Now a play fake. Lance winds up and lets it go for Samuel. And this one taken in on the right sideline, but not in the field of play. They say it's incomplete. The throw led him a little too far. It brings up third down.
A deep ball down that right sideline, and he made sure that he put it where either his guy was going to catch it or no one was.
And he can only manage to get this to the 45-yard line. Well short of the first. They get only four that time as that leads us to a fourth down.
Brandon, a good idea there on third down. Run a little clear out and hope you can get your receiver the ball coming across the formation. Nice design, but well played defensively, and they stop him well short.
They'll break the huddle here and go for it. This is fourth down. And they'll go for it. Lance. He's going to let this go. Back of the end zone. And this is going to be intercepted. Jeremy Chinn picks it off, and the Panthers are going to get the football here as the ball will come out to the 20. Quite a decision there on fourth down. They didn't just want the first. They wanted 6 points, and following the interception, they're going to come away with neither.
And that's too bad, partner, because they really went for it on that one, right? Because I think in their mind, sometimes the illogical play is a logical play. But in this case, they were wrong.
And he'll work this back to right around the line of scrimmage and surrender there. So we come upon. We now proceed to the start of the second half.
Plenty of adjustments likely being made by both teams in their respective locker rooms to find out who advances to the divisional round. Let's get you back out to Brandon Gott.
Okay, Coach, thanks as always. This one's still anyone's game as we welcome you back for quarter number three. Trey Lance of the 49ers set to go back on offense here.
And he's had some time to chew on that interception he threw on his last drive back in the first half.
Well, normally we say, well, get him right back out on the field and play again, right? But as you mentioned, had the halftime, had to stew about it a little bit. Maybe he'll have a chance to relax a little, kind of laugh and chuckle and let it go.
He'll hope to respond positively here to start the third quarter. To throw again on second down. Lance escaping the pressure right. I know it's an emotional game, Charles. You can't do that.
And when you get into your film sessions and you argue your case with your coaches, that's exactly what they say at the end. You just can't do it. It costs your team.
Off of play action, here's Lance.
He'll buy some, and he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down.
Sheldon Rankins able to get him for a loss of about three.
To try again after the sack. Lance flushed out right. Nothing open downfield, so he'll throw it away.
Well, defensively, they haven't let him just sit in the pocket and get comfortable, and that's opposite a lot of game plans in today's NFL. Ordinarily, you're trying to keep the quarterback hemmed in. In this case, they brought the heat, and if he flushes out, they're fine with that, and they force another incompletion.
Open man is IU complete, and he is going to have a 49ers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Lance a handoff here to Mostert. And a short gain there down to the 37-yard line. Credit him with a one-yard gain there to make it second and 9.
When we talk about defenders, specifically linebackers, keeping their eyes in the right spot, he had that eye down the entire time.
And you know that's not easily done because they throw a lot of misdirection at you. They try and fool you and get your eyes in the wrong place. But you're right about that one. He correctly figured that one out and made a really nice play.
Throwing his Lance on third down.
Sliding out of the pocket. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete.
And he is going to have a Niners first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
And a nice call and really good execution there because they gave him a little bit of a different launch angle perhaps, you know. You don't want to have the quarterback dropping back 5 to 7 steps on every play and have the defense zero in on it. There you hope that you get your defense going one way. They sent him the other, and they picked up nice yardage with that completion.
3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and 7.
Lance looking to throw it.
And this one's incomplete. George Kittle, the receiver that he was looking for. Third down here.
That was a nice job defensively of disguising their coverage and making it difficult for the quarterback to lock in on a receiver. And it results in an incomplete pass.
Here's Lance to throw it.
And that's going to be incomplete. The contact there enough to jar that ball free. And it brings up fourth down.
My first thought is surprise because that's one of the better tight ends around, and I've seen him pull in balls like this before. But how about a little credit to the defense forcing that incompletion?
Oh, this ball hangs out to the right. It's no good, and this score will stay right where it is. Down here in the third quarter, obviously that's one they could have used.
Yeah, and one of my favorite special teams coaches in the NFL told me what separates the kickers in the NFL versus the ones who are not is not the misses. It's the second miss in a row. Best kickers in the league, they don't miss two in a row. He's got to get his head back together in case he gets another shot.
As they began this drive, I was wondering how they were going to attack since they're playing with the lead. Would they continue to try and push the ball downfield? Well, after one play, it appears that the answer is yes.
And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 37-yard line. Now we've got whistles and a timeout here. Yeah, it looks like we've got a 49er that's down on the field. While the training staff works on him, we'll step aside and be right back. On second and 12, Stafford. And he's got his big tight end here.
Personal foul. Roughing the passer. Defense.
So they will accept the penalty and move forward. So now a fresh set of downs. First and 10 after roughing the passer. Out of the gun, Stafford. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. A gain of 8 there on the play, and it'll be a second down.
Nice rhythm throw there on first down. He located his tight end, made a nice easy pitch and catch.
Hoping he can break a tackle or two. Wasn't able to do that there, but still good yardage. Play action, Stafford. Over the middle, complete. It's Moore. Touchdown, Carolina. DJ Moore. Saving his best for the playoffs with his third touchdown of the game. And the Panthers, they widen their lead. Point after, right down the middle. And that makes this a 9-point game. Now following the touchdown, Hoffrichter to kick off. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. On first and 10, here's Lance. He'll swing this out to Mostert. And he's upended after a gain of 2 out to the 27.
All defenses worry that whenever anyone catches the ball and has a head of steam coming out of the backfield, it could turn into a big play with missed tackles or he runs through people. But they were right there waiting, and they stopped him for a minimal gain.
Rolling to his right. On the run, he'll let this go deep right side. And that will be incomplete. Trying to dial up the long way out there, but it'll be third down. Deebo Samuel was the intended receiver, and it's third down. Throwing now is Lance. Flush to his right. He'll have a first down past the 40, and he's going to be out up around the 45-yard line. Now after the completion, we're going to get a timeout, an injured player. While the training staff takes a peek, we'll take a break. On first and 10, it's Mostert. And no room that time, getting it to about the 46. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9. Now, they struggled to get him rolling on the ground in the first half, and that's sort of continuing here in the third quarter.
Yeah, but I don't think it's time to abandon the running game. I would say keep feeding the horse, and I believe he'll eventually reward them, especially as we get deeper in the game.
And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. A big play there on the catch and run.
But one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
They'll roll him out right. This is caught. And they are able to stop it, but he does take it all the way to the 2.
That's a big league job there, getting out of the pocket, not panicking, and just buying himself some time. Then he made a good, accurate throw to set up first and goal.
They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he'll take this into the end zone for a San Francisco touchdown. Elijah Mitchell taking it in from 2 yards out. And the 49ers are able to cut into this deficit here in the final minute of the third. The extra point up and good. And the lead is down to 2. Following the touchdown, Rohrwasser handles the kickoff duties. Donovan Peoples-Jones now from the end zone. And he had no room to run as he's tackled down inside the 20. DJ Moore, the Carolina offense, about to take over once again.
This defense, they wouldn't mind not seeing him again for a while. 3 trips to the end zone. How about that?
I think right now, they would happily go to their general manager and and say, is there any way you could get a trade for him? Bring him over to our team so we don't have to cover him anymore? Because he is really having a heck of a ball game, isn't he?
Boy, he is. I don't know that mid-game trade's going to happen, but good thought. And he almost gets this to the 30, taken down about a yard shy. Back now here in Santa Clara. One quarter remains in this NFC wild card matchup. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. On first down, Stafford here. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Picked off by Stephon Gilmore. A seismic shift in momentum here in the fourth quarter. That's the break that the defense needed.
And you know as well as I do, people are going to question the play call in that situation. Sometimes you have to question the execution, not necessarily the call. And in this case, those defenders found a way to give their team a chance.
3 yards the gain there, second down. Now Lance. And he rifles one incomplete. He was trying to get it to George Kittle. It's tight end. And it's third down.
The coverage was good, but I just wonder if they absolutely fooled the quarterback on that play. I think he was expecting something else. Ended up with nowhere to throw the football successfully.
From the gun on third down, Lance getting this out to the flat. Mostert. And he is going to have a 49ers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
And here we are in the fourth quarter. Watch him drive for what would be a go-ahead touchdown. And you and I both know this is where you need a quarterback who can keep his cool back there. Not just for himself, but to keep the rest of the team relaxed too.
They get him to the ground right on the cusp of the red zone after a pickup of 5 or 6.
I think we can safely say that those types of plays are the backbone of this offense. We know not every run's going to be a big hitter, but you know they'll take that type of result on each and every attempt.
He'll buy some time right. This is caught. And the 49ers are looking at first and goal as he's tackled all the way down at the 2-yard line. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
And this one will wind up with him losing yardage back to the 4-yard line. Now whistles here, and it looks like we've got a Panther that's having some difficulty down there getting up. From back at the 4, here's second and goal. We'll check on his status when we get back. They go back to the ground, this time Mostert. And he's going to take it in. Touchdown, San Francisco. Raheem Mostert, his second touchdown of the night. And the 49ers have retaken the lead. The late turnover is so often the difference in a ball game. And here, the turnover leads to the go-ahead touchdown.
So repeat after me, partner. You have to take care of the football. In order to protect the lead, you must take care of the football. Ball security. How many times do they have to say it? They've been preaching it since day one of camp, and it came back to bite them right there.
They'll try and throw for it. Sliding out of the pocket. And this one's caught. And their fourth quarter lead grows by a couple more. So they're able to throw it in for the two-point conversion. Sometimes that can be a risky play, but they got it.
Yeah, you always have to be careful here because if you do get it intercepted and it's returned by the defense, that's 2 points for them. But he identified an open target and put it right on him.
And he's only going to make it to the 13-yard line and no further. Here comes Matthew Stafford now to lead his offense back out there. And the interception that ended their previous drive, that might be one we look back on and say that was the turning point of this game.
Hey, partner, guess what? There's still time for a few more turning points in this ball game. They're only one score down.
Yeah, true. I mean, we could have some twists and turns. Stay tuned. And that is incomplete. Oh, the coverage a little too good there, and it's second down.
Normally, you think the tight end's going to be able to catch the football and handle that contact. But in this case, maybe a little too much target to hit. That one was timed well. Incomplete.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. The give to the fullback on the dive. And able to get it across the 20 before they get to it. Now after the running play, we've got a man down on the field. While the trainers take a look, we'll step aside. They'll fake it. Now Stafford. Looking left side, that's caught by Moore. And he'll be out of bounds right at the 40. His big game continues. Already has the 3 touchdown grabs, tacking on some more yardage and a first down.
And how precise has his route running been in this game? We just saw him get open yet again. He's also made adjustments as the defense has tried to really stop him.
Looking for more there on first down, but this throw downfield, incomplete.
Similar to a shooter in basketball, just connected on the previous shot. They run another set for him on the next play. Now, we had a guy who made the catch. They tried to get the big one downfield, but came up empty.
To throw on second and 10, Stafford. Throwing the out route and complete. That's Parker. And he's able to get this to the 40-yard line before he's out of bounds.
That's a pretty throw right there. That ball's in the air a long time, but it's right on the money on the right sideline. A really good route. Moving the defenders towards the middle of the field before breaking to the sideline. What a completion there. Big-time arm strength. Very nice route.
A hit as he throws there. Incomplete.
Oh, that's got to frustrate him a little bit because they nearly got to him there, and it would have been the first sack of the game instead. They're able to influence the release, and they did force the incomplete pass.
On the give, this is their fullback. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. No gain on that one as it brings up a 3rd and 10. Nice job there defensively to clamp down because really, they've been on their heels this drive.
Agreed, and they really needed that one for confidence, just to feel a little bit better. But I don't know if I would be daunted by them stopping me on one run. This drive has gone pretty well. I could come right back at them.
And that is incomplete. By the way, I got to apologize because I just realized for about the last 4 or 5 plays, I'm eking over in your territory up here in the booth. My bad. I'm going to get back over to my spot.
Yeah, we're not talking about our on-air commentary. I mean, what is all this extra paper? I mean, this is unusual
right
for
up.
You.
My bad.
Normally you run a really tight ship. What's going on here?
Just like that incomplete pass, I'm going to try to tighten things up here for this next play. But just kicking a field goal there, that's a decision that could be open to second-guessing. You know, you try to get back within a field goal, but it didn't work out as planned.
And now you're banking on your defense to be motivated enough to get out there and get the ball back for you. I think if that ball goes through the post, the defense is naturally motivated, even elevated in their mission. Now, they've got to find a way to dig down deep and get it done.
And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. So this will be accepted as it moves the offense backwards. They hand it off to Mostert. And he'll get this up past the 45 and the 47. 40 yards rushing for him now with a couple of touchdown runs to boot. And when do they start thinking about burning these timeouts? They've got all 3 still defensively.
To me, you have to start right now. Here's the time, and that means you've got to stop them on defense, not give up the yardage, use your timeouts in order to get the ball back and try and score yourself. But now is the time to start using those timeouts.
And keep in mind, it'll also stop the clock at the 2-minute warning. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. This is something you got to be wary of defensively. I mean, just because they're in the mode of trying to burn some clock doesn't mean they won't pass it, and they got good yardage out of that one.
Yeah, and really, when you're looking at it, now they've got a fresh set of downs. Look for second down. If they want to take another shot and try and loosen things up, that'd be the time to do it.
And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. And this is not something they want to see. George Kittle, such an important piece to the puzzle, is still down here. So after the run for no gain, here's 2nd and 10. Well, he gets attended to. We'll step aside. 2nd down, here's Mostert again. Pretty nice aggressive run there before being brought down just inside of the 30.
Now, the objective there, I mean, yes, the positive gain, that's nice, but work some clock.
Yeah, you're exactly right, but the problem for them is still within a possession, so they can't just sit on it running the ball. They'll have to find a way to throw it effectively as well.
Lance going to try and throw on third down here. Buying time to his left. And he will slide to a stop. He does have the first down. Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game. So it's 49er football here as we get you reset. They've got a first and 10 as they look to try and finish this one off. And he'll fight his way down inside the 10 to the 9-yard line. Yeah. So fresh out of the 2-minute warning, and here's another timeout taken with 1:55 remaining. And the last run got three. Now here's second and 7. Once again, it's Mostert. And running room hard to come by here. He gets it down to the 8. And now with 1:52 to go, we get another pause in the action. A timeout here defensively. Seventh play of the drive upcoming here on 3rd and 6. Lance now to throw. Rolling to his right. And this is caught. And that could seal it. It's a touchdown.
It would be really easy to say that they are firmly in control right now, but I'm looking at your face and I'm thinking I've got to be careful with that.
Well, it's a 2-score game. You're inside of 2 minutes. I think you can breathe relatively easily now.
Yeah, you can, but still, you got to stay vigilant. Can't give up anything cheap and easy. That could put you in some jeopardy.
And the formula there on the 2-point try to go 5 wide, not even the option to hand the ball off. They got it.
They tried to create space, and there isn't a whole lot of it there. For the defense, what you're trying to do is make sure that someone, if they're going to catch the ball, make them catch it behind you because they run out of space with the back line. But in this case, the offense figured it out.
So Matthew Stafford and the offense, down by 2 touchdowns, just over a minute 40 to play. Throwing is Stafford. Gets this to Moore, and he'll be out of bounds at the 25-yard line. 3 yards the gain there, second down. From the gun, here's Stafford. Connects with Slayton. First down now, but the clock continues to move. Stafford. Once again, he finds Slayton. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. Now, after the completion, we're going to get a timeout, an injured player. While the training staff works on him, we'll step aside and be right back. Throwing again is Stafford. And the Niners get there and bring him down. Stafford barking out signals and trying to get his guys set quickly. And he's got his man in stride, complete. And he'll be out of bounds after getting this one across the 40.
It's pretty easy to overlook the fullback when you're making your assignments defensively in the pass coverage game, but in this case, they made him pay for that oversight and picks up a nice gain.
Now a downfield. And unable to connect. Incomplete. Give them credit. They took their shot, but it's going to bring up 4th down.
That means it's just one last chance left, and this has to be a first down or a touchdown, or this game's over.
Desperation time for Stafford on 4th down. He's going to let it fly. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. They had to go for it with such little time remaining, and as a result, their playoff run may end right here. So with that, we can just about close the book on this one, Charles.
Yeah, what's the old expression about slim and none? Well, slim just left.
There he goes, left side. Touchdown, 49ers. Raheem Mostert.
saving his best for the playoffs with his third touchdown of the game. And the Niners continue to show why it pays to play at home in the postseason as they add on to their lead. Well, Raheem Mostert, we know the story, from special teamer to postseason hero. All he needs is a little bit of space, CD, and he can do the rest.
And no success stopping him on the ground all game long, because that's his third touchdown of the game and by far the best touchdown of the bunch. They came into this game knowing that they needed to rely on him, and the defense knew they needed to slow him down, yet he's delivered in a big way, and he's been sensational.
Peoples-Jones going to elect to bring this one out. And tackled at the 21-yard line, so a net negative there of 4 yards. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And at this point, maybe you say, you know, it was a good effort. Really, their season is just a few minutes away from ending in one-and-done fashion. Now the Panthers going to signal for their third and final timeout as they'll stop the clock with 12 seconds to go in the football game. They'll get this underneath to McCaffrey. And the Niners will continue on as we say so long, everybody.
Subconscious mind that I have only seen in dreams in my unconscious mind. My dreams unrefined, swing the mind, a state of mind that make it seem this lucky life of mine is predesigned. And if it is, then thank the Lord, cause that's the mastermind.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Crystal. Look, I played the game, I missed the shot, I had the incident, forgot I knew one. finesse, for my mana, manapalex. And I fell out and cut the check, mana, manapalize the set. But I've been taking hits like I can't die like any. Morning of the day, the dawn of the dead. Day. I don't see nothing but red. I gather the blankets and milk and the bread. I come from the east and I'm traveling west. Got a machete, I chop and I chop it. The nigga, the server, determine the plot and the threats. It ain't no stopping a run, popping son of God, dropping anybody who next. I want a mansion, I got a million advances. I'm gonna stay in Atlanta. Most of them move to LA and throw all of their money away and move back with their parents. I see the canvas, I got the brush in my hand. The colors are mixing again. Grabbing a stick with my hand, I drop my gush. The world is us, so what? Who wanna touch? Who wanna rough me up?
Nobody.
My head is ready to bust. Kicking the door when I come at the cut. Well, yeah. Who wanna touch? Who wanna rough me up?
Nobody.
My head is ready to bust. Do what I do and I say what I want. Well, yeah, mama, your kid in the magazine, kid in the magazine. I had a stack on my jacket at Grammy. We see the audacity. I was a bad kid, bad city. You see the duality. Who trying to battle me, huh? Hitters is after me. Can I be dabbing you? Who wanna fuck me up? Fatality really is up. It's up, undoubtedly. Baby, gon' touch the bucks. My salary double. Your baby daddy maybe triple. I'm trouble. I get the tackle in the pick and I hustle. I had to have it. Had to get in the huddle. In the gravel and rubble. Got me a sack and I'm trying to be subtle. We just hacking like a dog with a muzzle. See the bagger, put him back in the puddle. We attacking better. Stand back and watch a run. Shotgun come with the option. Send big blitz. Nobody blocking. Big win. That's a ring and a watch. Strong in when he come in a slot. Trying to bend a corner.